I am an archaeologist and a museum curator.
For my museum, I collect things,
but I also return things back where they came from.
I love museums because they're social and educational.
But I'm most drawn to them because of the magic of objects.
A 1 million year old handout. An impressions painting will take us beyond our own imaginations. In museums, we pause to muse, to gaze upon our human empire of things, meditation and wonder. I understand why U.S. museums alone host more than 850 million visits each year.
Museums have become battle grounds. Greece seeks the return of the Parthenon marbles, a collection of classical sculptures held by the British Museum. Egypt demands antiquity from Germany.
New Zealand's Maori wants to see return ancestral tattooed heads from museums everywhere. Yet these claims pale in comparison to those made by Native Americans. Already, U.S. museums have returned more than 1 million artifacts and 50,000 sets of Native American skeletons. To illustrate what's at stake, let's start with the war gods.
This is a wood carving made by members of the Zuni tribe in New Mexico.
In 1880, anthropologists began to collect them as evidence of American religion.
They came to be seen as beautiful, the precursor to the stark sculptures of Picasso and Paul Klee, helping to usher in the modern art movement.
From one viewpoint, the museum did exactly as it's supposed to with the war gods. It helped introduce a little-known art form for the world to appreciate. But from another point of view, the museum had committed a terrible crime of cultural violence. For Zunis, the war god is not a piece of art. It's not even a thing. It is a being. For Zunis, every year, priests ritually carve new war gods, breathing life into them. They are placed on sacred shrines where they live to protect the people and keep the universe in balance.
No one can own or sell war gods. They belong only to the earth.
And so Zunis want them back from museums so they can go to their shrine homes.
To fulfill their spiritual purpose.
What is a curator to do?
I believe that the war gods should be returned.
This might be a startling answer. After all, my conclusion contradicts the refrain of the world's most famous archaeologist.
That belongs in a museum.
Is what Indiana Jones said, not to just drive movie plots, but to drive home the unquestionable good of these museums for society.